Did you know that taking NMN and NR supplements could be potentially harmful to you? In this video, we'll cover four ways that these supplements, also known as NAD boosters, could harm you, and how you can minimize your risk. You've likely heard that NAD levels decline with aging, and low NAD levels are thought to contribute to fatigue, weight gain, diseases, and aging. To lessen the NAD decline, some people take NAD boosters. The problem is that most of us don't know the baseline levels of NAD in our bodies. Anti-aging experts, such as Davis and Clare, recommend testing the levels of these substances in your body before taking any supplement, if possible.
You can't just take something or do something and hope that it's working for you, because everybody's different. It's allowed me to see what works and what doesn't.
The reason being is that you already may have sufficient levels of NAD in your body, especially if you eat a proper diet with foods that are rich in NAD precursors, exercise regularly, prioritize sleep, and manage stress well. Too much of a good thing, like too high NAD levels, may turn out to be bad for our health, just like with many other substances, even vitamin D. One way to reduce your risk is with NAD at-home test kits offered by companies such as Do Not Age, Renew by Science, and Genfinity. Another risk is that NAD boosters could be depleting methyl groups inside your cells. If you don't know what methyl groups are, they're small molecules made up of a carbon and three hydrogen atoms that play many roles, from turning genes on or off to helping proteins perform their duties. When NMN and NR are broken down in cells, this process uses up methyl groups.
The thing with nicotinamide mononucleotide, NMN, is that it has this nicotinamide group on it. The levels of nicotinamide go up quite rapidly after taking NMN or NR. It becomes methylated into methyl nicotinamide. Is this drain of methyl nicotinamide a problem? I take it as a precaution because I know that trimethylglycine is not going to hurt me.
Ultimately, low levels of methyl groups could lead to cancer, heart disease, neurodegeneration, or accelerated aging, which is obviously the opposite goal of anyone taking NAD boosters. To lower your risk of adverse effects, take molecules that directly or indirectly replenish methyl groups in our bodies, including trimethylglycine, also known as betaine, B vitamin complex, containing all B vitamins such as vitamin B12, vitamin B9, and vitamin B6, or choline. A third risk is that some brands sell low quality, quantity, or purity of NAD boosters. Supplement manufacturers aren't held to the same quality standards as drug manufacturers. You should make sure that the NAD booster you're taking is of high quality and free of fillers. Here's looking at you, USP Labs. Did you know that a third-party test of NMN products showed 64% had NMN levels below the detection limit? Here's how to make sure you're getting the good stuff.
GMP, which is a certain grade of material, GMP, you want to look for reputable suppliers. And the material should be light gray or white. Otherwise, it's gone bad.
Make sure that the product comes from a reputable company. There are several out there, such as Do Not Age, Novos Labs, and Renew by Science. Check the manufacturer adheres to quality practices, especially good manufacturing practices and international organization for standardization norms. Make sure that the product has 100% absolute purity. Check the product is tested by an independent third party for quality, quantity, and purity, including levels of heavy metals, bacteria, yeast, mold, and toxins. Lastly, it's useful to measure the effect of any intervention. You could do this indirectly by assessing your energy levels after taking NR or NMN, or determine your biological age through blood biomarker or epigenetic testing, or you could find out your NAD levels directly with an at-home NAD test kit, as discussed before. Taking supplements regularly can stress your body, especially your liver. Many supplements, including NMN and NR, can tax your liver and potentially lead to liver toxicity or hepatotoxicity, as seen previously with other supplements such as green tea extract. Two simple solutions to minimize the risk of overstressing your body are: do not take more than the expert recommended dose, and cycle off of taking NR or NMN for a day or two every once in a while to give your body and liver a break. This is good practice for most supplements.
Even with supplements, I tell people that a lot of supplements you shouldn't be taking every day. Your body arrest, or maybe one day a week at least.